Hello everyone, today I'm back with another video. Today is going to be the 20 questions tag, and I have written down 20 questions from the original poster ZZ with books, and I'm going to be running through all of them, and maybe you'll get just a little bit more insight to my likes and dislikes, I guess. So question number one is, how many books is too many in a series? 4 books is too many, or 20 books is too many? Depends on what series it is. I don't really read that many series books. I would much rather prefer to read standalone books. Question number two, how do you feel about cliffhangers? I think that cliffhangers are a necessity. However, if there is a cliffhanger at the end of a book and there's no continuation or follow-up with that book, then it does get a little bit more aggravating. I feel like that's a little bit of lazy writing, because whenever you're just left to your own thoughts and you can make up what you want to think happened at the end of the story, I feel like that's not my story to finish, and so the writer needs to finish it. Question number three, hardcover or paperback? I prefer hardcover. It's just a different kind of reading experience for me. But ebook and audiobooks, I can barely get with them. Since I started to use my blue light glasses pretty regularly whenever I'm on my phone, tends to not stress my eyes as much. So that has made me a little bit more inclined to be willing to get books from like the Libby app and online stuff. Number four, what is my favorite book? I'm waiting for the day that I'm gonna find a new favorite and stop yabbing about my old favorites from this year. I really love The Miniaturist by Jessie Burton. Number five, what is my least favorite book? I really hate to even give this book, like just to say its name over and over, the poster child for the least favorite book, and I think that's by a mass, it's not just me. But my least favorite book is From Blood and Ash. I really just despised the storytelling and the way that the author did bring up content that needs to be addressed and fixed within society, but she didn't. She just talked about it, and then the main character was like, oh, I guess I'll just go along with it. And she learned absolutely nothing, and I can't even explain how horrible of a message that is. Moving on. Number six. Love triangles, yes or no? No. No. Because most of the time, a love triangle is the entire plot of the book, and that's the only storyline. They make it the A story, there's not really a B or C story. Number seven, what is the most recent book you DNF'd? I am on the brink of DNFing The Christie Affair because I don't like the protagonist, I don't like what their goal is, and I know that writers do that because they want to show the types of people that these characters are, and then I realized it was kind of a shite book. And so the book that I am going to read next, I'm thinking it's a toss-up between Demon Seed by Dean Koontz, or it might be the library book that I'm still currently borrowing called Circe. I don't know which one I'm gonna pick up first. I guess just whichever mood I'm in that day. If I'm in the mood for mythological fantasy, then I'll pick up Circe. But if I'm feeling horror, mystery, like thriller suspense-y, then I'll pick up Demon Seed. What is the last book you recommended to someone? I just recommended my fiance that he should read The McMasters' Guide to Homicide because I just got it. And I think that he would really like the dark academia aspect to it. And I also recommended him to read This Thing Between Us by Gus Moreno because, again, I feel like that is a more fitting book to his likes and preferences. And he's a really big fan of cosmic horror and horror in general. He could find a lot of appreciation for that in This Thing Between Us, I think. Number 10, what is the oldest book you've read by publication date? The first thing that popped in my head was my copy of Grimm's Fairy Tales, because by publication date, I have to be so gentle with this because it is very old. And I felt like absolutely no one actually opened it because there was nothing showing that there was any like sign of usage, any wear or tear. And this book is pretty old itself. This edition was printed in 1963 by Grosset and Dunlap Incorporated. And so I would say this is the oldest book by publication date that I have in my possession, in my physical possession. I think the oldest book I've ever read by publication date was The Castle of Otranto because it was published in 1794. Number 11, what is the newest book you've read by publication date? Probably Cold Clay right here. Number 12, who is my favorite author? Young adult fantasy, my favorite author for that is V.E. Schwab. For drama and mystery, my favorite is Jessie Burton. For murder mystery, it's Juneau Black. For horror, I don't know yet. I don't think I've read enough good horror books to actually settle on a favorite author yet. Number 13, buy or borrow. I do love having my own editions in my own house to pick up whenever I feel like it. So I like to buy physical copies But then again, I like to borrow digital copies. What is a book that you dislike but everyone else seems to like? The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. I can't get into it. I think it's way too much filler and non-chronological time order is so confusing.
I don't think that I answered number 15, but anyways, it was bookmarks or dog ear, and as always, it's bookmarks.
Number 16, what is a book you can always reread? I can always go back and reread the Shady Hollow series. I don't have to get involved in a big, expansive 500-page storyline with different time cuts and jumps. Can you read while hearing music?
And so this is a few days later and I am once again sick. At first I said that I didn't, which is true because I generally like to have silence while reading so that I can concentrate. But I got a few new books yesterday and one of them is a novelization of my favorite movie that I didn't know even had a novelization of. And I looked up on YouTube, music for reading this book. And so I made a short little playlist. I'll be adding to it the more that I want to read and listen to music for that book. I guess it just depends on how well I like the book and if it flows easily. Maybe because I already have seen the movie and adore it, I don't need extreme concentration for brand new content. So, okay, that's all I wanted to say. Bye.
Number 18, one or multiple POVs. I do like to read books that have one point of view, and some books that have multiple point of views I like a lot. I think that it's a great way to expand the story in a broader sense to all the characters because it gives you a little bit more omniscience that way. But if there's too many POVs, I'm gonna get lost in the sauce. Do you read a book in one day or multiple? Whenever I try to read a book, I try to read it in one day no matter what. With me, it's the same way with making crafts or just making something in general. I have that energy for that amount of time and that concentration for that amount of time and the willpower and motivation. Especially when it comes up on like the week mark, I get so tired of it. I don't want to see it anymore. I don't want to do it anymore. I remember I made a diorama a couple months back and then I just put it to the side and I was going to take a break from it and then I just never came back to it. If it takes me 2 or 3 days to read a book, that's fine. But I feel like if I'm coming up on the week mark and I haven't finished the book yet, I'm gonna DNF it because then I feel like I'm just not hungry enough for that story. A book you read because of the cover? This Thing Between Us by Gus Moreno is one of the only books I've ever gotten because of the cover. And I just thought that it looked so incredibly ambiguous and intriguing. And there were so many questions just from the very front that I bought it and I didn't regret it. I think everything that goes in with this is, of course, cosmic horror. And so when it's something as unknown as this and you don't know what the point of anything on the front is, that drives my curiosity to buy it. Prominently, this is the book that I read just for the cover. It was in the horror section, so I was considering it regardless. And I am extremely happy that it was a great book. So those are all the questions that are in this book tag. And I hope that maybe you find out a little bit more about my preferences and things that I do or don't like. And maybe you even find that you can relate to some of them as well. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.
You know what they say? Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. And always look on the bright side of life.